Hi, everyone. The COVID pandemic continues to wreak havoc in our communities. And so it is very important that at this time we do all we can to halt the pandemic. And I know you've heard this many times, but we at the Jesuit Institute really want to encourage you to wear masks, to distance, and also to sanitize. Many people are still socializing, and this is causing an even more rapid spread of this virus. So please do all you can to make sure that you protect yourself and protect others. It is also with great sadness that we at the Jesuit Institute say farewell to Father Anthony Egan. Father Anthony, after working at the Institute for many, many years, has been given a new mission. He'll be joining the Faculty of Theology at our Jesuit School of Theology at Hekima College in Nairobi from August. He was meant to have July off to have a holiday, but unfortunately has also tested positive for COVID and so is recovering and resting at the moment. Father Bruce Buerta, the parish priest of Holy Trinity in Braamfontein, has also tested positive for COVID, so please keep him in your prayers. Father David Rowan, who many of you are inquiring about, is still recuperating from a massive operation he had, but struggles with ill health and also cancer, and really appreciates your prayers and your concern. Now, despite the fact that the offices of the Jesuit Institute are closed at the moment, we continue to try and advocate for justice and also accompany you in this difficult time. Just last week, we launched This Is Home, a series, a campaign to try and to highlight the plight of stateless children. Children who either are stateless or will become stateless because of what the Department of Home Affairs in South Africa is doing. And we ask for your help. Sign on to this campaign. Watch the little video and also the witness of someone who is struggling because she finds herself in this position. Share this as widely as possible. And we are trying, by all means, with partner organizations to try and ensure that the Department of Home Affairs changes this legislation. We offer on Monday evenings for the next couple of weeks a half-hour prayer time for anyone who wants to join online at 8 p.m. Please contact us for more information. The email address appears on your screen now. In August, hopefully, we will see this pandemic tapering off, and the Institute offers a weekend retreat, Be the Architect of Your Life, at Sinkwazi in KwaZulu-Natal. Anybody is welcome to come to that retreat. After that, in September, from the 4th to the 12th, we offer an 8-day directed retreat, also in Sinkwazi, KwaZulu-Natal, a beautiful setting right on the beach with plenty of space for prayer, reflection, and rest. For more information about any one of those retreats, please contact us. The email address will appear on your screen now. And so we continue our work, we continue our prayer, and we ask you to continue supporting us because we really appreciate your support at this time. May God bless you all.